guys! Do you want to know about PFT or physical fitness test and learn to execute each test? Today, this video will teach you and help you to understand more about the purpose, the materials, and equipment needed for the test. And the most important topic is the test protocol or the procedure. Physical Fitness Test or PFT, introduced by Dr. Aparicio H. Mackey, former Chair of Philippine Sports Commission, PSC, and Director of Bureau of Physical Education and School Sports, or BPES, was conducted for the purpose of establishing testing protocols considered to be more current and appropriate for Special Program in Sport, or SPS. The Physical Fitness Test, or PFT, is a set of measure designed to determine a student's level of physical fitness. It is intended to test two categories of physical fitness, commonly referred as health-related and skill-related. Health-related components refer to those physical attributes which enable a person to cope with the requirements of daily living, such as cardiovascular endurance or stamina, muscular strength and endurance, flexibility, and the appropriate body mass index or BMI. Skill-related components are physical abilities that shows potential for good performance in certain skills, usually in sports, like running speed, agility, reaction time, or quickness, balance, and coordination. What are the objectives of this test? Physical fitness test objectives is to determine the level of fitness of students, to identify strength, weaknesses for development and improvement, to provide baseline data for selection of physical activities for enhancement of health and skill performance, to gather data for the development of norms and standards, to motivate, guide, and counsel pupils or students in selecting sports for recreation, competition, and lifetime participation. CPERT test. The purpose of this test is to measure and test flexibility of the shoulder girdle. Equipment, ruler, procedure for the performer, stand erect, to test the right shoulder, raise your right arm, bend your elbow, and reach down across your back as far as possible. Extend your left arm downward and bend your back. Bend your elbow up across your back and try to reach. Cross your fingers over those of your right hand as if to pull a zipper or scratch between the shoulder blades. To test the left shoulder, repeat procedures A and B with the left hand over the left shoulders. For the partner, observe whether the fingers touch or overlap each other. If not, measure the gap between the middle fingers of both hands and record the distance in centimeters. This table shows how you get the score. 0 did not touch the fingertips. 1 just touched the fingertips. 2 fingers overlap by 1 to 2 centimeters. 3 fingers overlap by 3 to 4 centimeters. 4 fingers overlap by 5 to 7 centimeters, and 5 fingers overlap by 8 centimeters and more. Sit and reach. The purpose of this test is to measure the flexibility of the lower back and extremities. Equipment: tape measure or meter stick, cardboard or paper. Procedure: for the performer, sit on the floor with the back, head, and shoulders flat on the wall. Feet are 12 inches apart. Interlock thumbs and position the tip of the fingers on the floor without bending the elbows. Place hand on the top of the cardboard or paper where the tips of the middle fingers are the top edge of the cardboard or paper. Start the test by pushing the cardboard or paper slowly and try to reach the farthest distance possible without bending the knees. Bouncing or jerking movement is not allowed. Do it twice. For the part of this test, as the performer assumes that the B procedures position the zero point of the tape measure at the tip of the middle fingers of the performer. See to it that the knees are not bent as the performer slides the farthest distance that he could. Record farthest distance reached in centimeters. Scoring. Record the farthest distance between the two trials to the nearest centimeters. Push-ups. The purpose of this test is to measure strength of upper extremities. Equipment to be used, exercise mats, or any clean mat. Procedure. For the performer, lie down on the mat, face down in the standard push-up position. Palms on the mat about shoulder width. Fingers pointing forward and legs straight, parallel and slightly apart, with the toes supporting the feet. For boys, straighten the arms, keeping the back and knees straight. Then lower the arms until there is a 90-degree angle at the elbow. Upper arms are parallel to the floor, maximum of 50. For girls, with knees in the contact with the floor, straighten the arms, keeping the back straight, then lower the arms until there is 90-degree angle at the elbow. Upper arms are parallel to the floor, maximum of 25 repetitions. Perform as many repetitions as possible, maintaining a cadence of 20 push-ups per minute or 20 seconds going down and 1 second going up. For the partner, as the performer assumes the position of push-up, start counting as the performer lowers his/her body until he or she reaches 90-degree angle at the elbow. Make sure that the performer executes the push-ups in the correct form. The test is determined when the performer can no longer execute the push-ups in the correct form, is in pain, voluntary stop, or cadence is broken. Scoring, record the number of push-ups made.